हेलो एंड वेलकम टू दृष्टि आईएएस इंग्लिश। आई एम आयशा। एज द लास्ट फ्यू डेज आर लेफ्ट फॉर द यूपीएससी सिविल सर्विसेज एग्जामिनेशन प्रिलिमिनरी एग्जाम विच इज शेड्यूल्ड टू टेक प्लेस ऑन 16th of June 2024, दैट वन डे दैट ऑल ऑफ यू हैज बीन वेटिंग फॉर सिंस लास्ट वन ईयर। ऑल योर हार्ड वर्क इज फॉर दिस सिंगल डे, इज फॉर दिस सिंगल date, that is 16th of June, when the prelims of the UPSC examination, UPSC civil services examination will take place. So it is about last few days that you have to pass by. So we thought that we should be sharing with you that what should be your last few days strategy or the last minute tips with you, or what can be the do's and the don'ts. So let's begin. And only few days are left, so keep up your preparation and keep up your motivation and keep yourself motivated, and in this scorching heat keep yourself hydrated, so that that one day, that 16th of June, is where you will have to perform, and that is the day when your preparation will matter the most, and what have you done in the last one year will show its result. So in the last minute strategy, or what should be the do's and the don'ts during the examination, is what we will be discussing. We'll be discussing what to keep in mind during the examination, what not to do, what to take into the exam hall temperament, time management, and how to fill the OMR sheet. So first of all, let's begin with what to keep in mind. So last thing, and as all of you know, that do not read anything extra. All you have to do is revise, revise, and revise what you have already studied, because studying anything at the last moment might be counterproductive. Then strategy to solve the paper. Do not follow anyone's strategy and do not go on what other people are saying. Make your own strategy, and by now you people must have finalized your own strategy how to solve the paper. Whether you people want to solve the paper in one go, or you people want to solve it in 50-50 scenario, like first 50 questions, then 50 questions, or four sets of 25 questions each, or first you will be solving all those questions which you surely know the answer, or then coming back to the 50-50. So your strategy should be yours. Then number of questions to attempt. Now there are different type of people. Like for example, there are people who play on efficiency. Like few of the people, if they think that the cutoff will be around 80 marks or 90 marks, then they will strategically plan that many number of questions. Like for example, if each question in GS paper 1 is about 2 marks. So if people think that they need to score 90 marks, so they will plan that 45 into 2 is 90. So they will be going on to attempt somewhere around 50 to 55 questions, keeping in mind the negative marking also. So the number of questions to attempt is what you have to think. So do not go by what other people are saying. You know how efficient you are while solving the paper. So keep in mind that what should be the ideal number of questions that you people need to attempt. Like for example, you need to attempt the questions between 80 to 85 or between 85 to 90. Nowadays we see that people are attempting questions, more than 90 questions also people are attempting. So make your own decision with regard to that. Then target to score much above the last year's cutoff. Like for example, if the cutoff is between 72 to 75 last year's, then you can say that day, then year before the last year, it was around 80. So do not target that you have to score just 80. Target around 10 to 15 marks higher. Like you should target that you have to score around 100. Because seeing the dynamic nature of the UPSC prelims, you may never know how the question paper is coming. So target much above what you expect and what you have already seen the last year's cutoff. Then CSAT. Now this is the paper 2, that is the CSAT paper. Even though it is qualifying in nature, you have to score 33%. But this is what is creating the problem. People are not comfortable with the CSAT. Do not ignore the CSAT. Practice, practice, and practice. This is what will make you clear the CSAT and make your own strategy, that whether you will be doing the math question first or reasoning question first or comprehension. If you are doing the comprehension, then how efficient you are in comprehension and how quickly you are able to do the comprehension, because many a times you might get the answer of the comprehension wrong. So this is a point which should be very much of importance to you. Then speed of attempting the paper, because the paper is lengthy, make sure that you are able to at least read the paper twice. In one go, you are able to attempt all the questions which you know for sure, and then at least you have the paper that you can read it twice also, so that the questions which you have left in the first go, you are able to attempt it in the second go. Then what to attempt first? Like for example, if you think that your strong area is history or polity, then look for the questions so that in the starting only you gain the confidence by marking the questions right. Then how many rounds to attempt the paper? Like if you do not have time or speed, then you will only be able to read the paper only once, but at least you should be able to read the paper twice. So look for that how many round of reading of the paper you need to do. 1, 2, many a times people do it even thrice also. Then UPSC day conditions, very very important. See, nowadays you are practicing and solving the mock test or the test series while sitting at your home. That temperature might be 20-25 degree, but when on 16th of June, looking at the conditions right now, the heat or the temperature outside is more than 42-43 degrees. So make yourself and your body and your mind used to those conditions, because the exam day, the real exam day conditions is what you will be going outside, and then what your body or you will be experiencing. Like for example, if there are two papers which UPSC takes, then sit on those time slots. Like for example, if the first paper is 10 to 12, then sit at the exact same time, and then take the 2 to 3 hours break, and then again sit for the second slot, so that your body becomes used to it and your mind is also used to the same conditions. And specifically look how you are going to spend those 3 hours in between. Then avoid avoidable mistakes. Time is precious. Like for example, do not waste your time on the questions which you know you do not know. Then manage your time that way, so that you can at least give more time to questions which you are able to select at least 50-50. Do not waste time on the questions which you do not know at all. Next, what not to do? So things which you should not do is, do not ignore CSAT. People have done it in their past attempts and they have paid the price. So be very clear with regard to the paper 2, that is CSAT, even though it is qualifying in nature, but people are not able to qualify. Many of the students who have performed much better in the paper 1, they were not selected for the mains examination because they could not qualify the CSAT. Then if you are someone who studies at night and sleeps in the morning, then you need to change your schedule, because UPSC conducts examination in the morning and afternoon session, not at night session. So your mind might not be able to work properly. Then because the temperature nowadays is so high, do not have health issues. Make yourself feel better. Be hydrated. Do not face heat stroke, or do not face dehydration issues. Then do not read anything new or extra. Then don't panic. This is also one of the major issues. Keep yourself calm during this condition and see how your mind is occupied, and you do not overthink. Like for example, what will happen in the examination, what will happen if you will not be able to clear the examination, all these kind of things, do not think about those. Don't eat heavy at night before the examination, very important, so that next day you feel light. And also with regard to the rising temperature which is going on outside, your body needs to feel light. Revise from notes, do not read complete books. This is important. Many a times you will see, if you will sit down and read the complete book, you will not be able to finish any of it. Then dehydration issue, and avoid overthinking. Then comes what to take into the examination hall. So when you enter the examination hall, what things you should be having, that is admit card, ballpoint pen, then passport size picture, ID proof, water bottle and analog watch. And what you should not be taking with you, that is Bluetooth, any extra paper, digital watch or any suspicious material or anything. which can get you in trouble. Do not take it. As in the coming days, the admit card will also be issued. So you will also get in detail that what you should not be taking into the examination hall. Then exam hall temperament. How your mind should be during the examination, and that is you do not panic. That is the basic thing that you need to manage. You need to manage your mind. Then psychological disadvantage, if the first few questions becomes wrong, very, very important. It happens with many people. Like for example, imagine you are starting with the question paper and first 5 to 10 questions you are not able to get it right. Then a person starts to panic, and that is very obvious. Imagine that you are the thing for which you have worked so hard in the last 1 year or last many years, and you're not able to get the first 5 to 10 questions right. Do not panic. Then look for the question or the section which is your strong point and start solving the paper from there on. And then get back to the starting of the pages or the starting of the question paper, and that will give you confidence. That will make you feel motivated, that will make you feel positive, that will make you feel energetic. Then stay hydrated, very important, because even though it sounds very small, but in the end, if your body is not with you or your mind is not fresh, then all your hard work might not work. Then what works well for your mind? Make your mind refreshed so that your thinking ability is at its peak. Plan 2 minute breaks accordingly or 1 minute break accordingly. Like for example, your 2 hours, how you are going to plan your 2 hours. Like for example, many people does it that first they solve those 50 questions, then they take a 1 or 2 minute break, then they solve the other 50 or 25 25 25 25, or when they read it the paper in the one go, after that they take 1 or 2 minute break and then they read it again. So that is up to you how you do it. Don't be in a hurry, might commit mistakes. That is, for example, it happens with the OMR sheet. Like for example, imagine this is question number 17, 18. Now a person wants to fill the question number 17 answer, but if he or she in a hurry, he might mark the answer in front of the 18th. And now with this, you do not lose one question, you lose both. It is a grave mistake during the examination. Now time management. As each paper is of 2 hours, manage your time efficiently. Do not waste it, because the most precious thing during the examination is your time. That is everything for you. So paper 1 is merit based, so you need to think about the cutoff and then you have to perform. Paper 2 is qualifying, that is you have to score 33%. Even though you have, it is just qualifying, do not take it lightly. This is what is creating problem nowadays, that CSAT. Don't waste time on any question. If you do not know, skip that question. Complete paper from your end. The number of questions you want to do it. How you want to do it. Do not think, and it should not be that you have not read the paper completely. You are not able to read all 100 questions. That should not happen. You should be able to at least read the paper once completely. So that is up to you how you manage your time, because the paper is lengthy. Then keep an eye on the time always. First solve what you know, your strong point, which will make you feel good. Go for it in the first go, which will increase your confidence also. Now OMR sheet. While filling the OMR sheet, you should be extremely alert and be very, very, very cautious. And till now, because you people are attempting the prelims, till now you people must have solved many tests or you have solved many test series, so you must have practiced filling the OMR sheet. But still during the examination hall, many people commit this mistake. Be very alert while filling it and practice many a times. Don't waste much time also in filling the OMR sheet, like you are giving 15 to 20 minutes while filling the OMR sheet. That should also not happen. Make your own strategy. Like for example, how do you want to fill the OMR sheet? First, you want to fill for first 50 questions, and then in the second go, the other 50 questions, or 25, 25, 4 batches you have to fill, or when you are done with one paper, in that 5 or 6 questions are there, then you have to fill. So that Till now, while doing your test, you must have developed your own strategy. All you have to do is, you do not have to make mistake while filling the OMR sheet. And you do not have to give much time while filling your OMR sheet. And OMR sheet, you do not have the scope of making a mistake. Then, use thick nib pen. Like for example, a very, very light pen, you might take extra time to fill the bubble. So while filling the bubble, your strategy should be, you should be able to do it quickly, very, very quickly. Then be careful about the question number and the related bubble. Very important. That is many a times is what people make mistake. Like question number 11, 12, 13, because they are so much in a hurry that they will mark question number 11 answer into question number 12, question number 13 answer into question number 14. And that not only gets you one question, that gets you many questions in line. And then it harms your mental peace also and your mind also, because you start to panic because you have already gotten a wrong question and that you are aware about it also. So that is what can cause problem for you. So these were few of the tips from our side for you people that you need to take into consideration while going and giving the UPSC prelims paper. And these are few of the do's and the don'ts. And in the end, I would just like to say that 16th of June is the day for which you have worked so hard. 16th of June is the day for which your all the hard work, all the sacrifices, whatever you have done in the last so many years, it is that one day that will count the most for you. So till now you have been motivated, you have been energetic, you have been calm. So continue that. It is about few more days. And in the end, I would just like to say that the time is now and it's your turn to shine. Because it is your turn to shine and it is that preliminary exam which you will pass, and then you will go on to give the mains examination and then the interview. And that 16th of June is what is, that should be your day to shine. So this was all from our side. Keep on watching us. Keep on watching our videos. And that's all from our side. Keep reading, keep writing and keep subscribing to the channel. Thank you.
For more informative content, like, share and subscribe, and do not forget to press the bell icon to get the notifications.